Do you remember the first computer you ever used, or the TV you once watched cartoons on? It's easy to take modern technology for granted, but if you compare it to the room-sized computers of the 1960s, you'll notice how quickly things have changed, or rather, how much they've shrunk. As technology advances, the amount of data we need to store and manipulate is increasing, and the size of devices is decreasing so much that conventional techniques of data storage won't be good enough for long. Most modern technology is electronic. It uses a property of electrons called charge to encode information. One example is computer memory, often called RAM, which is where computers keep information they're working with for several seconds or minutes. RAM contains billions of tiny plates called capacitors that hold electrons. To store information, computers send a current of electrons into the capacitors. Some of these electrons collect on the plates. If the number of electrons on a capacitor is above a threshold, the computer assigns it a value of 1. Otherwise, it's a 0. Unique patterns of zeros and ones encode information like letters, numbers, and images. As chips get smaller, so do capacitors, and we are faced with a problem of charge leakage. Electrons constantly slip away from the plates. When the electron count falls below the threshold, the stored data is lost. To avoid this, computers have to recharge their capacitors several times per second, which requires more and more power as chips shrink. Fortunately, an emerging technology called spintronics could solve this problem. Spintronics uses spin, another property of electrons, to encode data. The spin of an electron is either up or down. It is helpful to think of spin-up electrons as little magnets with their north poles pointing up, and spin down electrons with downwards pointing north poles. Data is stored based on the spin states of electrons that are already present. This means that there's no problem of leakage with spintronics. Once information is stored, it stays there until we want to change it. The spin states of electrons change if we actively influence them by exposing them to magnetic fields. To take advantage of this, scientists developed Magneto Resistive Ram, which replaces capacitors with tunneling magnetoresistive structures. TMR structures are made up of an insulator sandwiched between two ferromagnetic materials. An insulator is a material with very high resistivity. This means that electrons are very unlikely to move through it. A ferromagnet is a material in which the spins tend to align along the same direction. The lower ferromagnetic layer is fixed. Its electrons are forced to have the same spin as each other by an adjacent strong magnet. The upper ferromagnetic layer is free. Its electrons change their spins in response to external magnetic fields, or through a phenomenon called spin transfer torque, which is where electrons change their spins to match the spins of nearby flowing electrons. When the spins of the ferromagnetic layers are parallel, the structure stores a 1. Opposite spins represent a 0. To read the data and determine whether it's a 0 or a 1, the computer sends a tiny current through the TMR structure. If the spins of the top and bottom layers are parallel, electrons can tunnel through the insulator. Tunneling is a process that is similar to a basketball moving through a solid wall. It's normally very unlikely, but parallel spins make it possible. If the spins are opposite, almost no electrons tunnel through. By seeing how much current reaches the other side, a computer can tell whether the structure is holding a 1 or a 0. To write data, we send larger currents up or down the structure. Sending electrons up the structure from the fixed layer to the free layer switches the value from a 0 to a 1. Because of spin transfer torque, the flowing electrons adopt the fixed layer spin as they move through it. The electrons in the free layer then flip to match the spins of the flowing electrons. Since the free layer responds to changes in external magnetic fields, which are generated by both computers and living organisms, TMR structures have numerous applications beyond computers. When a neuron in your brain fires, your heart beats, or a white blood cell attacks a virus, tiny magnetic fields are created. A spintronic sensor chip could detect the smallest deviations from your normal magnetic fields, detecting anything from bacterial infections to brain tumors. Because magnetic fields are not altered by the structures they move through, it could even do this from outside the body. And because electron spin changes are near instant, spintronics technology could do so quickly. Ultimately, spintronics technology holds promise in countless areas, from computer memory to medicine and beyond.